because she holds that thing sacred. And unless somebody gives her permission to say something, she's not going to say it. Whether it's something that was told to her on the job, whether it was something told to her by a friend, whether it's something that she's not going to tell you. Don't ask her. She's not going to tell you. And I admire that. I really, really do. Because I always have to kind of like flip the switch in my head and say, oh, wait a minute, I can't tell that. Because I'm a person that likes to talk. And I'm a person that likes to fix things. And sometimes I think that I can fix something by sharing something. Y'all looking at me like I'm the only one. I'm not the only one. A lot of times we want to run in and fix something. And we feel that the information that we have can help fix or heal a situation. We don't mean no harm. You know what we say? I mean no harm. But we don't know what other actions are in play. We don't know what God is doing trying to fix the situation. Many times we put ourselves, we insert ourselves in a situation trying to make ourselves little gods so that we can fix it. We don't even give God a chance to do what he's doing because we all up in it. I'm just talking about myself this morning. Because this message is for me. Amen. It's for me. It's for me. It ain't for the rest of y'all. It's for me. Because even though I didn't mean no harm, God is going to judge me. Because it's the law. Amen. It's not a good idea. It's the law. And I have got to recognize that I can't make myself a little God.
Yes.
It is so difficult in this age and time, this information age that we live in. It's just information and news, and this is changing and that's changing, and he who has the most information wins. You ever felt like that? You ever hated to be not in the know? Oh yes, you have. Walk up on a conversation. Y'all talking about? Because we hate to be left out. We want to be in the loop. We want to have the information so that we can, you know, exercise a little control, or exercise a little, what do we like to say? A little authority, you know, because authorities have the news. They have the information. Come on, somebody. But it's all in his hands. Amen.
Amen.
Everything we commit to God Almighty. And when we start talking out of turn, we take things out of his hands.
Yes.
And that is serious business, folks. And he made me realize today how often all of us usurp his authority. And we do. And we don't even think about it because we've been anesthetized to that law. Because we say, I'm not bearing false witness. I'm not lying on anybody. But it's not just lying. It's tale bearing. It's taking information from place to place. And you haven't been given the authority to do that. It's not a jump up and shout message. But it should be a search me, Lord, help me get this leaven out of my cabinet. Let me get this sin out of my life, because truly, God can't operate in me as long as I'm breaking the law.
Amen.
Amen. Many times we forget that it's important for us to allow him to wash us and cleanse us over and over again. I'm through, y'all. I mean, you can't get no more message than that. We forget that every day, I remember the old people used to talk about being unspotted from the world. You know, got my garments white. Well, how about you can't keep white every day, all day, without brushing up against something that's gonna put a spot on. That's why we don't like white, wear white, amen? Because it gets dirty so quick. But we're supposed to be fit vessels as unto the Lord. We're supposed to keep our garments white. And for me, one of the best ways of keeping my garments white is keep my mouth shut.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. See, I don't mind telling you. Because you know, once we start telling stuff, and I'm going to say this and I'm going to be finished. Once we start telling stuff, that thing gets good to us. We start adding stuff. You know, wasn't even there. But we can visualize the child. They told me that they was on the corner with such and such and so and so. And then by the time we tell it to somebody else, they wasn't on the corner, they was in her house. Say, you know we go there. You know we need to be washed from this stuff. I'm telling you the truth. We really need to be. Because, just in case you hadn't heard, time is winding up. The Lord is soon to come. There are so many things that are taking place in the earth today. And we ask, why hasn't Jesus come? Or why we're in certain situations that we're in? Or why doesn't he answer our prayers? It's because we've broken the law. We've talked out of school. We said some things out of turn. We didn't think that God was listening. We didn't know that it mattered. If you didn't know that it mattered, he overlooked it, but you know it matters now. I just taught you. It matters. What you gonna do about that little information I just gave you? How are we going to handle information from this point on? We can't just fall on our knees every time we mess up and say, I didn't mean to do it, Lord. We're gonna have to ask God to keep our tongues so that we won't do anything. And it's hard. I'm not going to lie to you. It's hard. Not that I've been out there lying on everybody, and not that I've been telling people secrets, because I haven't. I really have not. But there have been times when I wanted to fix things. Be little God and fix it. And maybe this information that I have can help fix this situation. I surrender this morning because I'm going to let God be God. What about you?
Amen. Amen.
I think if we move forward from this point and allow God to be God in our lives, we're going to see more miracles wrought. We're going to see more souls saved. We're going to receive more blessings in our lives because we've surrendered our tongues. Let us stand to our feet. Father, we thank you for the permeating power of the Holy Spirit this morning. We thank you, first of all, for the spirit of conviction. Convicting each and every one of us who have stepped outside of the authority that you have given us and tried to walk in your authority. Lord, we ask that you would forgive us and cleanse us. and the weaknesses that we have in ourselves that makes us want to make little gods out of ourselves, we ask that you would free us, cleanse us, take it away, Jesus. Wash us. Help us to be holy. Sanctify us. Sanctify our minds. Give us a different way of thinking, a different way of speaking. Hallelujah. Lord, we ask today that you would show us how to walk on a plain path. That you would show us how to bow down and worship you wherever we find ourselves. Not just when we come into your house, but when we wake up in the morning in your presence, help us to bow down and remember that you are the King of the universe, that you are running this thing, that this is your earth, this is your world, and we just live in it. Help us, God, today to recognize who you are and to understand that it's not by might, not by power, but by thy spirit, saith the Lord of hosts, that we will be overcomers. Make us overcomers today, we pray. Help us to be the people that you desire us to be, so that your soon coming kingdom can come. This world is reeling and rocking, Lord, and we need you to come save us, but cleanse us and fix us before you come is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We used to sing a little song.